worship, and one big embrace. Here we go. 1, 2, 3. We love you, Emma. We're gonna do one tremendous horror. I want the family in the middle. Everybody else will be outside. There you go, there you go. Let's close it up, let's close it up. All right, we've got another circle. Let's build another one, let's build another one. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Let's build another one. Here we go.
Last one, last one, last one.
Mashiach, Mashiach. I did that circle to the right. left.
Take it back.
Take it back.
Before us and read from the Torah with strength, pride, and love of his Jewish identity. Today he truly embodies our pride and our heritage and our hope for the future. While this is only one chapter in a life that will continue to be filled with love, family, friends, and learning, we take this moment to celebrate the person Evan has become now that he is a bar mitzvah. In celebrating the honor, decency, and humanity that define Evan, we also celebrate each of you and the role you've had in Evan becoming the young man he is today. Whether you've been part of his daily life, have seen him at moments throughout his life, or know Evan more from the stories his proud parents have shared with you, we thank each of you for coming from near and far to share in this moment and for being such an important part of our lives. Evan is the young man he is today because of the deep love and support of his family and the rich heritage of the Spencer and Wolf family histories. Evan embodies the traits of his great-grandfathers, men of honor, devotion to family, and unwavering decency. Isaac Leib, who was lovingly known as Papa Lou, in whose honor Evan has the middle name Isaac. Dov Yoel, in whose honor Adam has the middle name Yoel. Morris Wolf, in whose honor I have the middle name Moshe. And Morris Cohen, in whose honor Melanie has the Hebrew name Menashe. We also honor Evan's great-grandmothers, Sissy Spencer, who was lovingly known as Nana Sissy, Seema Cohen, Etta Yoel, and Rose Wolf, whose legacies of unconditional love are the foundations upon which our families are built. Of course, we honor Evan's Sof and Pa, my mom and dad, who have been part of the fabric of Evan's daily life since the day he was born, and have instilled in him so much of the love of learning, generosity of spirit, and simple decency that he embodies. Words are insufficient to express our gratitude for your generosity and all that you have given of yourselves each day of our lives to help us all arrive at this moment. We also honor Auntie Florence and Uncle Manny for their incredible generosity, devotion, and love. They are Auntie and Uncle, but they are truly like another set of grandparents. who have treated Melanie and me as their children, and Evan and Adam as their grandchildren. We are so profoundly grateful to have your unwavering love and support. Evan and Adam are so fortunate to have grown up with such a rich family life filled with the fun, love, and generosity of Uncle Stu, Uncle Rich, and soon to be Uncle Eric. As soon as we're done here, we have a wedding to prepare for. And his aunts, Auntie Bronwyn and Aunt Keely, who early on wanted to be called Tia G, but that never really stuck. We say a special thank you to Uncle Stu and Diego for being the winners of the Who Traveled the Furthest to Be Here contest by making the trip from Hong Kong. Evan and Adam have also been fortunate to grow up with the best cousins kids could have. We thank Maya, Jesse, Bella, and Brandon for sharing so many special, memorable moments with us. Even though the circumstances of life never allow us to have the cousins together quite as much as we would like, we are always blown away by the deep connection you have with each other, how you bring the best out of each other, and that no matter how much time passes, you always pick up with each other right where you left off. And that is truly a gift that we pray lasts your lifetimes. Of course, Evan is the best big brother to the most loving, devoted, and supportive little brother. Adam will be giving his own speech in a few minutes, so I'm here as the warm-up act. I figured I should speak before him because, since I've already heard the speech, I'm quite certain it's not an act I want to follow. And finally, we honor the memory of Brandy Ramah, who undoubtedly would have relished this moment. She loved a good party. Of course, her spirit is here, and her legacy of strength and courage endure. Her legacy is embodied in Melanie, Evan, Adam, and the entire family. We love her, we miss her, and we celebrate in her honor. And as we celebrate tonight, I want to thank Melanie for coordinating everything that had to come together for making this Bar Mitzvah weekend and this once-in-a-lifetime party possible. The first Bar Mitzvah in Irvine City Hall history was her inspired idea. And this party is truly a labor of love. She coordinated with calm clarity and vision in the midst of the profound responsibilities and challenges of daily life. You never cease to amaze me. I love you. So in case you didn't pick up on the subtle cues, I'll tell you that Evan has a love of politics that may only be equaled by the Clintons, and to give equal time to his political affiliation, the Bushes. Are there Kleenex anywhere? Not only is this his passion, but I believe it also defines the most important aspect of what Evan's Bar Mitzvah represents, which is that he is, always has been, and always will be his own man. He is a young man who charts his course and is always guided by his principles. While I tease him, and at times shed a tear about it, Evan is a modern-day Alex P. Keaton. And of course, that means that he considers himself to be of a political persuasion that differs from his parents. Yes, we are Elon and Melanie Wolf, and our son is a Republican. I'll be calling my sponsor after the party. During the past few years, Evan has developed his passion for politics by reading voraciously about American government, political history, and current political issues. He has analyzed and taken notes while watching debates, State of the Union speeches, and more than his share of Sunday morning political shows. I'm not kidding you when I tell you that the kid has reams of notes comparing the current presidential candidates' tax plans. He has also written to past presidents and has received responses that hang in his room, and which we only half joke will someday hang in his presidential library. Unfortunately, I can't vote for him. Evan has developed his own political ideology and his view of the world, albeit one that will continue to evolve as he does. As a bar mitzvah and a young man of great intellect, insights, and abilities, it is Evan's responsibility to be a contributing member of the community to help lead it. Republican or otherwise, we trust Evan to always be guided by his conscience and integrity, and to be the one who, if necessary, will stand alone to do the right thing under whatever circumstances. So while there are voter registration cards on the premises, and I'm happy to go grab one and check D on Evan's behalf, we will leave him the responsibility of making his own decision about which box to check when the time comes, as we will all the defining decisions of his life. And since we know Evan well enough to know that it will probably still be an R 5 years from now, we trust that regardless of his political affiliation, Evan will always use his wisdom to help those who most need it. As many of you know, mostly because I couldn't stop talking about it, a couple years ago, Evan wrote to all the Supreme Court justices. He received several responses, the most meaningful of which was from Justice Sonia Sotomayor. She wrote Evan a personalized letter in which she concluded, "Always remember that dreams can come true when you work hard to achieve them. In the years to come, I wish you the joy of dreaming big, working hard, and succeeding in all that you do. Amen. I love you."
On that note, there are so many people who have contributed to this event in my life that I have to thank. Firstly, I have to thank Jenny Kudoshin for planning this event and setting everything up. I thank Rabbi Mendy for helping me with the Torah and Haftorah portions I presented yesterday at synagogue. Rabbi, thank you for helping me with my portions for so long. I would like to thank my grandparents, Ora and Al Wolf, for being caring and dedicated grandparents all along the way. I thank my brother Adam for being such a supportive brother. And lastly, I would like to thank my parents for their devotion and helpfulness. Thank you for all the sacrifices you've made for me and for being the best parents ever. Thank you all for coming to celebrate this event with us. Enjoy the party.
Thank you.